Imagine waking up tomorrow morning and realizing you died in your sleep. For most of us, we would still be dreaming, having a nightmare actually. But what if I told you that some people truly believe they are the walking dead? It was 1880. French neurologist Dr. Jules Cotard treated a patient he referred to as Mademoiselle X. Her condition, so rare it had never been recorded before. She complained of feelings of anxiety and despair, along with claims that many of her organs, including her brain, were missing. She honestly believed that she was dead, so she never ate, therefore died of starvation. Dr. Cotard named this strange disorder negation delirium, to be later known as Katard Syndrome. This is Dynamic Science. Time to find that comfort blanket because we are about to delve into Katard Syndrome, one of the rarest and strangest mental disorders. Also known as Cotard Delusion or the Walking Corpse Syndrome. This rare condition is marked by a range of delusions in the patient's relationship with their body. This condition can take on many forms, such as the belief they have rotting or missing organs, they are a walking corpse, or simply do not exist at all. In rarer cases, one may even think they are immortal. It is important here to first understand the term delusion. A firmly held belief which contradicts the evidence and is not shared by others around you. The hypothesis is that those suffering the delusions associated with Cotard syndrome fail to recognize their physical self, thus do not relate to their bodies. There are two elements of the syndrome, one is associated with anxiety and depression, the other delusions, and three stages it presents itself in. First, germination. The patient suffers psychotic depression and feels anxious about their health. The second, blooming. Patients fully develop the syndrome, therefore the delusions take hold. And in the third, chronic stage, chronic depression and a complete distortion of the world develops. It is here that the use of reason or any rationale at all to convince the patient anything other than their delusions becomes near impossible without multiple levels of intervention. Therefore, everyday personal care like hygiene and eating become obsolete, just like Mademoiselle X. Cases have been reported in patients with mood and psychotic disorders, hallucinations, hypochondria, and those who suffer from self-harm. Cases have even been reported in individuals with impaired renal function. In 1996, a Scottish man who suffered a brain injury in a motorcycle accident believed that he had died during the recovery process. When his mother relocated him to South Africa, the heat actually convinced him he'd gone to hell. In 2013, writer Esme Weijun Wang thought that a fainting spell several months earlier had been her death, and now she was being made to live in an unending purgatory that resembled her old life, which had originally led to her anxiety and depression. A 2008 case study documented the experiences of Miss L, a 53-year-old Filipino woman who terrified her family with her complaints about her death. She said she was rotting and couldn't stand the smell of her flesh. When she told her family to take her to the morgue, naturally they called 911. Apologies if all this has made you feel a little uneasy. To put your mind at rest, I will reiterate this disorder is extremely rare, with about 200 known cases worldwide. The causes are still not clear, however, it is often a symptom of deeper medical issues affecting the brain and is most prevalent in those who are in their early 50s, those who have a history of mental health problems, and those who have experienced some form of brain damage due to strokes, tumours, or blood clots. And while this ever so strange condition still baffles doctors, these days most people do get better, with treatments like psychotherapies or talk therapies such as CBT, coupled with medications such as antipsychotic, anxiety, or depressants. And if these do not help, electroconvulsive therapy is an option. So, if you do happen to wake up as a zombie, rest assured you have most likely been watching too much Walking Dead, and you're still fast asleep. Enjoying the content? Then shout us a coffee. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel for your weekly dose of dynamic science.